second trick is quantitative versus qualitative. Okay, when you have a quantitative statement and qualitative options, then options could be wrong. Okay, we will go through questions for this. Quantitative statement means what? It shows some quantity, and qualitative statement means it tries to judge something. Okay, we will go through question first. Now, a decrease in tax to GDP ratio of a country indicates which of the following? Okay, the first statement is slowing economic growth rate. Second is less equitable distribution of national income. And third is, there are only two statements. Then select the correct answer using the code given below. Now, you know what is GDP? GDP is final value of goods and services produced in a particular geographical territory. Okay. If it is India, final value of goods and services. Decrease in tax to GDP ratio. Tax upon GDP. Tax means just a collection of money. And GDP is final value of goods and services. It is also in terms of money. Now, if your knowledge, if you know what is GDP, if you know what is tax, you can easily solve the question. But let us see, you don't have any knowledge regarding whether the decrease in tax to GDP ratio, whether it leads to slowing of the economy or not, whether it is led to a less equitable distribution of national income or not, you are not sure. But still, you can solve the question based on our this trick. Qualitative versus quantitative. This is a quantitative statement. It just gives a quantity. Quantity of, let us say, how much tax is collected and how much is the GDP of the country. But it doesn't give any indication regarding distribution of that national income among the citizens. Okay. It doesn't give us an indication that some people in the country are poor, some people in the country are rich, some people in the country are employed or unemployed. That kind of data is not available by using tax to GDP ratio, right? So in that case, this statement is directly wrong. Any problem? If you go through GDP, from GDP you won't get any data on equitable distribution of resources. How many millionaires are there in our country? How many BPL people are there in our country? That kind of data is not available from GDP ratio and tax ratio, or GDP data or tax data. That is just a financial number. What is GDP of our country? It's 2.6 trillion. It just gives an indication of how much wealth is there in our country. It doesn't give an indication of distribution of that wealth in our country. Right? Hi, you can.
So sure that it will give only growth.
We are as of now thinking about statement 2. Okay. We will go to the first statement then. Okay. Now you can remove these two options. Clear? Now we will come to the first statement. Slowing economic growth rates. Now we are thinking in terms of tricks. Okay. The first level of our understanding, our approach to solve the question is your knowledge. If you have knowledge, you can directly solve the statement. If you don't have knowledge, you can use the trick. You can use the logic and common sense. And thirdly, you can use these tricks. Now, see this. Tax upon GDP. Okay. Slowing economic growth rate means what? GDP rate has declined. Okay. If tax collections decrease, that also means that the ratio is decreasing. Okay. If this ratio declines, if your GDP is good, your tax collection will be in proportion. You will have sufficient tax collection. If tomorrow if tax collection decreases, in that case, this ratio will decline. GDP, this is a GDP, not GDP growth rate. GDP growth rate, now GDP, let us see, in our country is GDP 2.6 trillion. As of now. And tax collection, let us say 1 trillion. In the next year, if tax collection decline, that ratio will come down. 2.6, let us say the GDP or the economy in 1 year, it has grown by, let us say, 10%. Okay. So that GDP in the next year will be 2.6, 10% of this addition. This will not change drastically, but this will change drastically. If you see recent corona pandemic, tax collection have declined to a very large extent, but GDP is declined just by 9%. So in that case, this has declined more than this. So a decrease in tax to GDP ratio, it can show slowing economic growth rates. Okay. Now, if you don't have knowledge, you have to use this conception, you have to use this kind of logic or understanding, and in that way, you can solve this, such questions. Anyway, let us say if you don't know anything, at least you can remove this statement. You are not sure about this, but at least you can remove this. At least you can solve the question 50%. Only two options will be available with you, either A or either D. Let us see, if you are not able to think about this, you can either go with this or this. At least 50% chances will be there to make it a correct answer. Right? We'll go with the next. Now, see this question. Increase in absolute and per capita real GDP cannot. You have to identify the keywords and underline them whenever you solve a question, because every keyword will give you an answer. Okay. Increase in absolute and per capita real GNP cannot a higher level of economic development. If you know GDP formula, in that formula, export, import, investment, savings, those words are used. Okay. Whenever you find a GDP, then you will have three different GDPs: manufacturing GDP, agriculture GDP, services GDP. Increase in absolute and per capita real GNP, gross national product. GDP and GNP, there is a difference. Okay. And both are related. Either you decrease externally added values. Okay. What is GDP and GNP? GDP is gross domestic product. And GNP is gross national product. Okay. Domestic means in our country, whoever produces something, that comes in GDP. Suppose if a Nepali person comes here, earns something, he will take that money back. And if an Indian, if he is working in Nepal, he will bring that money in India. So addition of those things, subtraction and addition, that will give to GNP, gross national product. GNP and GDP, both are nearly same. Just there is an addition of external income. So that means you have to keep one thing in mind. Whatever GDP or GNP is there, you have to think in terms of what is there in the GDP. If you think there are three formulas of GDP, either you can go with that income, expenditure, import, export. That is one formula. Second formula is you can add GDP of, let us say, agriculture plus GDP of manufacturing plus GDP of services sector. Okay. This much understanding is sufficient. And per capita GDP means you are dividing this by population. Whatever GDP or GNP is there, you are dividing it by population. That is per capita. Industrial output fails to keep pace with agricultural output. Increase in absolute or per capita GDP. Let us see, if you don't know anything about this. See, industrial output and agriculture, both are there in GDP. Don't think about this. Okay, now come to second. Agricultural output fails to keep pace with industrial output. Let it be. As of now, we won't think about this. We will come to third. Poverty and unemployment increases. How will you get this information from GDP, which is just the addition of these things? From this, is it possible to get the data regarding poverty and unemployment? If I say our GDP has increased from 2.6 trillion to 2.8 trillion. Is it possible to know about poverty rates in our country from this data? Then why do we need special labor surveys? Why do we need special employment surveys? Why do we need a BPL category or that SISC, socioeconomic caste census? Why do we need? If we can get this data from GDP, then why do we need these surveys? You are getting my point. GDP doesn't give any indication regarding this. You can directly go with this. Import and export, they are part of the GDP calculation. As I have told you, there are three ways to calculate GDP. Those are based on either sectional GDP and then added together gross value addition. Either this could involve expenditure, savings, that is income, expenditure, import, export. Okay, just go through GDP calculation. You should have GDP GDP related basic understanding. GDP, GNP are nearly same, just there is an addition. Okay, is this possible? Is there any doubt? If you have knowledge, you can directly go with the answer. If you don't have knowledge, you have to think logically. I can't go with this. I can't go with this. I can't go with this. But I can go with this. This is the answer. Because this data is not available in absolute or per capita real GNP. Correct? Any doubt? Agriculture output you know. But the data in the agriculture we won't be knowing. Like how much land is owned by who? Like how much... Which crop has more productivity? Agricultural output means a total output of agriculture. Final value of agricultural output. What is GDP or GNP? It's a final value of goods and services in the country. Agriculture is the good. Whatever final output of the agriculture, that is agricultural GDP. Okay, that's why we know. Agricultural output we know, that is included in GDP. Industrial output, that is included in GDP. Then import and export are also included. At least with this knowledge, you can easily solve the question. This data is not available. If I say the GDP of USA is, let us say, $19 trillion, is it possible to know that what is the poverty rate in USA or what is the employment rate in USA? In case of India, if we have that knowledge using GDP, then we wouldn't have labor surveys. Every year we have labor survey, periodic labor survey. Then we have social economic caste census. Okay. So that thing is not available. Like these things are not available from this data. You can easily remove this. Even if you don't have a deep understanding or the quantitative status, whether what is our absolute GDP, what is per capita GDP, you don't need those things, but you can easily solve the question. Any doubt? We will go to next question.